Hey everybody, this is JD Gaming, back today with another episode of The Best of Yu-Gi-Oh! You guys seem to really enjoy that first round of weird OCG normal monsters, and I'll be honest, I had so many good ones that I had to look through back then that I figured, let's give those guys a shot as well. So today, we're going to be looking at some other weird monsters that never made it overseas from Japan because of weird artwork, naming, flavor text, or something along those lines. Up first is Air Eater, which you'll look at this thing and think, oh, classic Yu-Gi-Oh! Must be some sort of flying soul-eating monster, right? Well, if you read its text, you find Air Eater is actually a monster that feeds on oxygen, suffocating any who stand near. Yeah, this guy literally eats all the oxygen in its vicinity, suffocating his opponents so that they can't survive. That's where those 2100 attack points come from. Akakiesu is a sorcerer who utters spells that render monsters unconscious. Kinda sounds more like some educators you may have had in your lifetime than a Yu-Gi-Oh card, doesn't it? On top of having this magical ability, the spellcaster wears royal red robes and has tons of gold. How nice. Not to be confused with Seto Kaiba's ancient Egyptian identity, Ancient Sorcerer is armed with an array of magic wands, and this creature is capable of multiple attacks. Except he's a normal monster, so he doesn't have any such ability, so maybe it's kind of a waste that they gave him two extra wands to hold with his headdress. But I guess it's not all bad. I mean, look at this guy. He seems pretty excited about it. Yeah. Arlune is a lady monster dwelling in a flower. She sprinkles the air with poisonous pollen. If you guys saw the Weird Fusions video, you may recognize this creature as basically an alternate version of Rose Specter of Dun, which was an odd fusion monster that used Feral Imp, of all things, with Snake Yashi. But the additional flavor text that Arlone gets takes the cake. Remember, she spreads pollen, which, if you think back to your high school biology class, is the male plant particle, and it specifically says that this creature is a lady monster. How exactly that's supposed to happen given the time this card was designed is beyond me, and I guess Konami R&D decided not to even bother trying to westernize it. Barrel Rock is one of my personal favorites on this list. It is exactly what you would expect it to be. Shouldering a pair of machine guns, this monster is unstoppable. Yes, that is a giant golem made up of small to large bricks and other rocks. It's literally got barrel guns on his back, and just look at those hands. He definitely gets brownie points for those weird hands. Bolt Escargot is a monster that renders an opponent immobile by spitting a sticky goo. Afterwards, it will close in for the attack. At what speed? Well, if my childhood has taught me anything, I think the real menace in this race is the rock we just talked about. Change Slime is very similar to a lot of the other creatures we talked about on the last list. It's a slime that, as you would expect, can morph and adopt the shape and size of any monster it chooses. But once again, why on earth, of everything it could have chosen, did it choose this green thing with a single sickle coming out of a deformed head? You had so much potential, Change Slime. I'm disappointed in you. Continuing our line of Transformers, Eye Armor is a warrior who can transform into various creatures to confuse enemies in battle. But regardless of what it finally chose as its ultimate form, I'm pretty sure if I saw this thing running towards me, I'd be puzzled. Dreams are nice. After all, why else would anyone strive to be the very best that no one ever was? Well, Fungi of the Musk might need a little bit of a reality check. Clocking in at 400-300, this monster melts away anything that dares to stand before it. Maybe it's got a bit of a power trip from its original name from Japan, where it was the renowned plant of the demon world. As one of my very first Yu-Gi-Oh cards ever, Crab Turtle was one of my favorite cards that I owned. Apparently, he has a cousin from overseas. Ganigumo is a crab that binds its enemies with a sticky web and attacks them with its
big meaty claws!
Sorry, got a bit carried away there. Sharp claws. Just sharp claws. Hitodenchak is a rabid starfish that spits a lethal acid that can melt almost anything. This just doesn't make any sense to me. A rabid starfish, so it has rabies and bites people, but instead spits a lethal acid that apparently is just on par with our buddy Fungi of the Musk. Icewater is a very aggressive mermaid that attacks enemies with the spikes growing from its body. So unless you're underwater where this thing can swim towards you with its abdomen, I'm guessing this thing can only attack you with belly-flopping body slams. Illwitch is a monster that blasts enemies with unexpected bursts of wind. Gesundheit. Kappa Avenger is an amphibian that sold his soul for to avenge his late friend. Following the link on friend on the Wikia takes us to Hyosube, which was actually a creature we featured in the Weird Fusions video last time. Perhaps he should have told his buddy what he was doing before he wished to become the Roaring Ocean Snake.
Rararyun
is probably the onomatopoeia they were going for. Anyway, this guy is an electrical cloud creature, and for some reason, even though it has the power of lightning, its acid rain is what makes it very dangerous. And it's even a thunder type. Majin Gun is a living weapon that spits projectiles, and this is more of a cool thing rather than a crazy weird thing, but this thing looks straight like a rip out of Final Fantasy or some other old JRPG. The Filet of Fish is a mechanized bass with a large mouth and a cannon on its back. The cannon fires blinding plasma rays. Mechalion is a large chameleon with the ability to alter its body coloring. Using this ability, it can conceal itself in any location. Wait a second, isn't this just a real-life chameleon? Why, yes it is, and so the first time I saw this card and its 800 attack points, I thought it'd be a pretty fun idea to take the maximum tensile strength of maybe a chameleon's tongue in the real world, convert that to 800 attack points, and then relate that to how strong Blue Eyes' 3,000 attack points actually means in the game. That's like an episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! Game Theory waiting to happen. Orion the Battle King was such a powerful ruler that none have lived to tell tales of this powerful battle fairy. Or so I thought until I reread this card and realized that if no one lived to tell the tales, maybe he was such a terrible leader that all of the people who would have written stories about him ended up perishing under his terrible leadership. Sea King Dragon is protected by a tough shell, and this master of the seas attacks its enemies with toxic bubbles. I can think of at least 5 specific reasons why Tentacle Plant would be considered on a lot of people's weird lists, but we're gonna get our minds out of the gutter here for a second and take a look at just the flavor text. A carnivorous plant that has an outgrowth of tentacles. It attacks someone nearby by extending its tentacles. Did you catch that? It doesn't attack something or some monster or some other creature. It attacks someone. Maybe the creators of this card did have that in mind after all. That Which Feeds on Life was a card that I never understood as a kid, but maybe it does have more sense to it than what I gave it credit for. This monster apparently seems to be the robes of some sort of spiritual priest thing, given the beads, and then his right arm is totally malnourished and has only 3 fingers and a thumb instead of a normal human hand, and he's like holding some sort of a crystal ball thing with this demonic face, and then his entire left arm and hand are either Dark Fire Dragon or Salamandra. But then again, you look at this flavor text, and it says it's a monster that feeds on the energy of other creatures. So perhaps the moral of the story here is you are what you eat. And there you have it. Somehow after talking about 20 of these guys last time, there were still 22 more of these things to discuss this time around. And if you missed that previous one, don't worry. There's not any specific order you have to reach them or anything. They're just all random in my random comments on them. And I have everything in the end card coming up, so you'll be able to check out the rest of the series if you so wish. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. And of course, I'm going to be doing this type of stuff for some of the TCG vanillas coming up as well. So don't you worry about that. But if you have other suggestions for things I might want to look into for these weird lists, definitely drop that down below as well. So thanks, guys. This is JD Gaming. Hope you guys enjoyed as always, and I'll see you guys next time. That's the end of this video. But if you'd like to see more of this series, you can click the annotation on the right, or you can see the last video I did by clicking the one on the left. If you enjoyed, I encourage you guys to leave a like and share it with others you think who may enjoy it as well. And if you'd really like to see more updates, then subscribe to JD Gaming for more Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos. Thanks, guys. This is JD Gaming. Hope you guys enjoyed as always, and I'll see you guys next time.